Hello, and welcome to this ArcherPoint presentation on using work type codes with jobs. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a senior pre-sales consultant here at ArcherPoint, and I'm here to lead you through this demo today. In the previous video, we looked at how to set up job task and planning lines. And in that video, I mentioned that we can use work type codes to drive different prices that are associated with different types of flat activities. So today we're going to look at how to set those up and how they're used. So going off of our previous example, we have a posting line here. As I mentioned in the previous video, we can go ahead and click on one of our hyperlinks to go into our planning lines. And here we have Lena, and we see that we have a quantity and work type code. Our unit cost is coming from our resource card, which we'll look at again in just a second. We see that there's a unit price for this that's based on a work type code of doing a diagnosis that is remote. If I change this to doing an on-site, then we see that price goes up to 150, or if I select in-house, then we can see it goes to 75. If I scroll back over and jump into Lena's resource card, first we can see that my unit cost is coming from the combination of a direct unit cost that I've established, as well as an indirect unit cost. So there's my 4804. And if I go to resource and all the way over to the right here, we have prices. Here's where I can set up different work type codes and different prices. And so by selecting these, I can set these up for various resources and have different prices for different work type codes. So it's a good way of being able to both have different default prices that are going out, but then you can also check and make sure that your unit cost, how much it's costing you, is going to be less than what you're ultimately billing. Hope this has been helpful. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments or reach out to us at ArcherPoint.com, and we will do our best to help you. Thank you.